See, you can only love out of strength. It takes strength to love. You got to speak with purpose. We think that our salvation is based on performance. God is not a man that he can lie. He don't lie. You be a vessel that God is worth. Because you somebody might need your holy prayer to save them when they... Nazareth is a very small little village. It wasn't until the 3rd century that Nazareth even made the maps or any mention in the Hebrew Bible. But I'm telling you that from this small village, our Savior was born. Jesus of Nazareth. In all the Gospels, in 3 of the Gospels, he's recognized as the Nazarene. And that's Matthew, Mark, and Luke. He's recognized as the Nazarene. In 2 of the Gospels, we have him being born in Bethlehem and then later on growing up in Nazareth. And that's up for great debate, which I'm not going to discuss on this video. But I do want to talk about Nazareth. It's a small village, and everybody in that village is cultivators or farmers. And they lived maybe about 100 families in that village. Jesus' father was a carpenter, which means he was one rung above being a beggar. Wasn't much carpentry work being done in Nazareth. This is where our Lord and Savior grew up. And the surrounding writers of the area that took note and of the historical events that was happening. This was a very chaotic time. There was a lot of rebellion going on against the Roman government and a lot of sedition that the Roman government had to deal with. And to the point that there were men and women that was rising up saying they were the Messiah, they were the King of the Jews, and this was sedition, and it was an edict out, a writing out, a law out that if anybody claimed to be the Messiah, they were going to be crucified. So as Jesus comes up in this volatile atmosphere, he begins to talk to the villagers and to the fishermen in his local community. He begins to do wonderful works and great signs proving who he was. And when he revealed himself at the Feast of Tabernacles, I believe it was, and they began to question where he was from. And the Pharisees said, well, no prophet comes from Nazareth. No good thing comes from Nazareth. Search the scriptures and they will show you that the king will come from David's city, Bethlehem. And so Jesus never refuted that. He began to talk about his origins, about where he come from, coming from the Father, but it was the Father God who sent him. Now, what makes this exciting to me is God made sure that there was no humanity other than him entering into humanity would get the credit for the Savior coming forth. He came from a very small family, from a very small insignificant village, and he entered into history with signs and wonders proving that he was our Messiah, the Savior of the world. This is a season that we're celebrating God's gift to all of mankind. Jesus came in and became the last Adam, the last of the humans that had to stand before God guilty and condemned was Jesus, because he took in on all the sins of the world and died. And in his death, he was judged. So now that all the world have died in Christ and been judged in Christ, we all together have raised with him. And there's a new creation. There's a new creation. And the life, the gift of God is in each and every one of us. And when we hear the truth about our Lord and Savior, it unlocks the key that releases the consciousness of his life in us, which makes it relational. We are relational. So faith does not come by your brain learning and proving every fact. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, and believing and embracing God's word and making it our own word. I'm inviting you to acknowledge the fact that God has already redeemed you. He's already sent his son to die for you. His son has died for you and has been judged for you. Now receive his gift of life and in receiving his gift of life, receive all that comes with it when you receive Jesus Christ and acknowledge him and embrace him as your Lord and your Savior. Well, this is Dr. Will Wheat, and I'm here to remind you that God has plans for your life, and none of those plans include